Okay, dear students. So today we will see the band reject filter. So the agenda of the today's class will be the new topic will be the band reject filter, and then we will have the revision of all kind of filter that we have seen till now. Okay, today class will limit ourselves. We'll first go through the band reject filters, and then in a summary we'll have the summary of all the filters. Okay, that will be that today they will have these things in a day class. So Letty, I told you band reject filter is also sometimes called band elimination filter or band stop filter. Okay, so band reject filter is having three name, either is band elimination or band stop. In syllabus it is given as band reject filters. Okay, so what is band reject filter? You just see here. In band reject filter, the frequencies are attenuated in the stop band while they are passed outside the band. So for a particular band, if you don't want a signal of that frequency, then you can use this kind of filter. So what will it will attenuate the in the stop band while they will they are passed outside this band. Okay, figure 5.11. Where is figure? Figure 5.11 shows a band reject filter using a low pass filter and a high pass filter and a summing amplifier. So prior to this topic, we have gone through band pass filter. There we are having high pass filter in cascade with low pass filter to realize band pass filter. Here also to realize band stop filter, again we using a two set of filters, low pass filter and high pass filter, but additionally we'll use one summing amplifier. Okay, once we see the circuit diagram it will be clear. So the third point is the low cutoff frequency FH. Okay, and the low cutoff frequency FH of high pass filter must be larger than high cutoff frequency FH of low pass filter. Clear? That means if you see the frequency response, this FH should be less than this FL. Or this since this is a high pass filter, so the cutoff frequency of high pass filter should be more than the cutoff frequency of low pass filter. So on the screen you can see the frequency response or a frequency characteristics of a band reject filter, where we are having two pass band, and this is the one first pass band, this is the second pass band. Okay, and one reject band and one reject band. It is in contrary to the band pass filter. Okay, where we are having two stop band and one pass band. Clear? So you can see if you divide the response of this band elimination or band stop filter into two parts, you can have this way. Okay, this way this can be considered the first half, and then so this, if you see this response, actually it resembles like a low pass filter. Clear? Now if you see the second half of the frequency response, this one, so it resembles like a high pass filter where cutoff frequency is FL. So again, using the combination of high pass filter and low pass filter, we can realize band reject filter. Okay. So this is the circuit diagram for band reject filter. If you will see, it is having two filters. This one consists of one filter. Okay, this is one filter. And what kind of filter is this? Since you can see the combination here, C is on this side and R is on this side. R is grounded and C is connected to V in. That means it is high pass filter. When you will reverse this, that means when R will come to this side and C will be grounded, capacitor will be grounded, and when it is low pass filter. So you will have a high pass filter and a low pass filter, and both will see here also non-inverting terminal, and here also this is non-inverting terminal. You should see this is also non-inverting terminal. And this is also non-inverting terminal. Okay, so the input is common to both. So here we will short this non-inverting terminal of this high pass filter, and this low pass filter will short and will give a common input, that is B input. Okay, clear. And these are the feedback gains RF, and this is the RI which decides the gain of the filter. Okay. And this is nothing but a summing amplifier. Okay. If you will see, the gain of this amplifier is 1, because R4 is also 1, R2 is also 1, and R3 is also 1. This is a just inverting summing amplifier. Clear. So any doubt in this diagram, in circuit diagram, you can ask me. Anyone having any doubt in the circuit diagram of band reject filter? Because it is very easy. Band stop is also combination of two filters, and band elimination, band pass, and band stop both are mere the combination of high pass and low pass filter. Clear. So anyone having any doubt in the circuit diagram? So again, come to the frequency characteristics of a band stop filter, okay, or band reject filter. Here we are having FH. FH is the cutoff frequency. This is the another cutoff frequency, FL, and FC is the central frequency. Okay, that can be found out using the relation root under FH FL, root under FH into FL. Now see, in the circuit diagram, this RF and R1, here in the feedback we are having RF and R1 for this high pass filter. For low pass filter, it has been denoted by RM dash and R dash. Okay, clearly here here we are having capacitor here and a resistor here. So here it is represented, capacitor is represented by C and resistor by R. Here it is represented, resistor is represented by R dash, and capacitor is represented by C dash. Okay, so you just for to differentiate the representation of these passive components for high pass filter, we are just using RF, R1, C and R, whereas for low pass filter we are using RF dash, R1 dash, R dash and C dash. Okay. So frequency response is also clear, I suppose. So now we'll come to a problem. So the problem is to design a band reject filter, design a band reject filter having FH, having frequency FH of 200 Hertz and FL as 1 kilohertz with pass band gain of 2. FH means this is the cutoff frequency. FH means cutoff frequency of low pass filter. Cutoff frequency of low pass filter, and FL is the cutoff frequency of high pass filter. That means you need to design a band reject filter which will reject the signal having the frequency between 200 Hertz and 200 Hertz to 1 kilohertz. 200 Hertz to 1 kilohertz. That means a band of 800 Hertz you need to reject. Clear? And the gain should be 2. The gain of the filter should be good. That is the requirement. So here it is given FL is equal to 1 kilohertz and FH is equal to 200 kilohertz. So similarly, you can do the design one by one. So you first take the low pass filter, derive the component. For the low pass filter, we have already seen the step, okay? How to find the components of a low pass filter. And for high pass also, we are having a design criteria. So for high pass, first we will see the how to find the parameter for high pass filter. So for that, C should be chosen less than equal to 1 microfarad. So here C is chosen as 0.01 microfarad. Once you're having C is equal to 0.01 microfarad, you have chosen, then from there you can find the value of R. Find the value of R. So this is a high pass filter. Now for high pass filter, the cutoff frequency is 1 kilohertz. So R will be 1 by 2 pi FL into C, or 1 by 2 pi 1K into C, or you will end up in having the value of R as 15.9 kilo ohm. Okay, so we got the parameters value for high pass filter. Similarly, we will go for the low pass filter. Again, in this case, we have taken C dash as 0.05 microfarad. We have taken C dash as 0.05 microfarad. Again, let me inform you that you can choose any other value also of C dash. It can be 0.01, 0.5 and so on. Okay, clear? So R dash. So similarly for low pass section, the R dash will be 1 by 2 pi FHC, where what is the value of FH? FH is 200 Hertz. So if you substitute the values, 1 by 2 pi into 200 into 0.05 microfarad, you will end up in having the value of R dash as 15.9 kilo ohm. Clear? So now you are having the parameters for low pass filter and high pass filters. Now again, since gain is 2, so for both the filters, the gain is 2 for high pass and low pass. So the RF should be equal to R1, okay? And also RF dash should be equal to R1 dash. So we have considered R1 is equal to RF is equal to R dash is equal to RF. RF dash is equal to 10 kilo ohm. All the four resistances, we have taken the value of its resistance as 10 kilo ohm. Okay. Now for the summing amplifier, the gain is 1. The gain is 1. Therefore, the R3 should be equal to R2 and it should be equal to R4. That is 10 kilo ohm. ROM is what? ROM just is the resistor that is used to reduce the biasing effect, and whose value is taken as R2 parallel R3 parallel R4. So this equation we have seen where, while we were discussing the summing, averaging, all those things, operation using amplifier, there we were using ROM, whose value was like this only, okay? So now, so overall design parameter we will have as T is equal to 0.01 microfarad, R is equal to 15.9 kilo ohm, C dash is equal to 0.05 microfarad, R dash is equal to 15.9 kilo ohm, R1 is equal to RF is equal to R1 dash is equal to RF dash is equal to 10 kilo ohm. Okay, R2 is equal to R3 is equal to R4 is equal to 10 kilo ohm, and ROM is 3.3 kilo ohm. So this is the all the design parameters for band reject filters, where the FL is 1 kilohertz and the FH is 200 hertz. Clear? Any doubt in this problem, you can ask. Any doubt in this problem, you can ask. Okay, then we'll just have the revision of all kind of filters that we have gone through. Just we'll have the summary. So what kind of filter we have seen? We have seen just four kind of filters: low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, and band reject filters. And it can be, so whatever we are going to study, the active filters. Active filters, why it is having active filter? Due to the include of op-amps. Since we are realizing these filters using op-amp, so that is why it is called active filters. Along with this, we will use some passive components like resistors and capacitors. So for low pass filters, this is the frequency response, clear? This for low pass filter is the frequency response. Here we are having gain 1. You can have any gain. In this frequency response, the gain has been shown as 1, but the gain depends on you. You can have any gain as required. Okay. So this broken line for low pass filter, this broken line shows the ideal response, but you cannot have this type of response in practical. The continuous line shows you the practical response. Now this roll off actually is decided by, if you see this is a you can have a minus slope is there, negative slope is there. So this roll off depends on the order of the filter. If it is the first order, then you will have minus 20 dB per decade. If it is second order, then minus 40 dB per decade. And if you increase the further the order of the filter, then it will be more closer to a ideal filter. Clear? Now, how it can be realized using the circuit components? By using op-amp and the resistors and capacitors. Okay. So high pass filter, similarly, for that, okay, again, for a low pass filter, you will have a cutoff frequency FH. Okay. For low pass frequency, we'll have a cutoff frequency FH. For high pass filter, similarly, we'll have a cutoff frequency FL. So just, we have seen all these things. A band pass filter will have two cutoff frequencies, FL and FH. Okay. Similarly, here we are having two stop bands. This is the first stop band and this is the second stop band. Okay. This one is the second stop band and this one will be the pass band. Okay. So we are in this pass band filter. We are having two stop band and one pass band. Where band stop or band reject filter, we're having two pass band and one stop band. As you can see here also, we'll have FL and FH. So now we come to the circuitry of a low pass filter. So we have seen this is a circuit diagram of a low pass filter. So the input will be given to non-inverting terminal. Here input has been given to non-inverting terminal, and this resistance RF and R1, it decides the gain of the filter. Clear? So now if you will have R and C in this manner, then it acts as a low pass filter, because we have already derived the voltage gain equation, and from there we have realized that from that voltage gain equation, the output V naught by V in is acting as a low pass filter. Clear? Now once you interchange the position of C and R, this low pass filter will get converted into high pass filter. Okay, clear? Now again, this is a first order filter. If you want to have a second order filter, same combination of this R and C network, same combination, you can add here. Okay, you can add one more here before the V in, then it will generate a second order low pass filter as shown in this diagram. See here, You can see this is the first network of RNC, this is the first network of RNC, and this is the second network of RNC. Okay, so if you will use two network, then we'll have second order low pass filter. You can see from this, we are feeding the output again again to the input at C2. Clear? We should remember this thing. Similarly, for same thing is for high pass filter. Only the change will be the position of RNC. Only the change will be the position in RNC. See, you can see this represents the high pass filter. Now C is here and R is here. Similarly, again for the second order high pass filter, we'll again use the network of C and R. Okay, one more network that will generate a second order high pass filter. Now comes the band pass filter. Design, we have seen all those things. So a band pass filter again can be realized using a combination of low pass filter and high pass filter. So first you'll have a high pass filter in cascade with low pass filter. For that we'll have the frequency response like this, okay, where this is FL and this is FH. Similarly, the band reject filter will again can be realized using low pass filter and high pass filter, but additional component will be a summer. So we'll have this summer, okay. So if you will use this combination, you will end up in having the band pass filter, and this design we have already seen. Now, any doubt till now? So just overview I've given of the whole filter and the frequency response also given. I think there should be no confusion in the frequency response, and also you should take care that, again I am repeating, for low pass filter the cutoff frequency is represented as FH. For low pass filter, the cutoff frequency is represented as FH, and for high pass filter, the cutoff frequency is represented as FL. FL, okay. And also, you see the gain magnitude equation for low, for first order low pass filter. It is AF by root under 1 plus AF by FH whole square. For second order, it will be AF by FH. To the power 4, like this. All those things equation you should be knowing. Any doubt in the filter, you can ask me now, okay, if you're having any. And next class we will move to the 555 timer, okay. So what is the topic? We will move to the last topic of the module 5, which is 555 timer and its application. So in the next week we will start 555 timer and its application. So there we will see monostable and astable multivibrator using 555 timer. First we will see what is the 555 timer and what it is basic operation, and using that we will have monostable and astable multivibrators. Okay.